Strap in, everybody. This is the most controversial thing I've ever said. There is no obligation to vote.
What?
Voting is a duty. What would Susan B. Anthony say? Hopefully that she fought for women's right to vote, which also includes the freedom not to vote. Thankfully, voting is optional in the United States, as it should be. In 22 countries, voting is mandatory, punishable by the government if you don't vote, which flies in the face of choices. It's a choice not to vote. There's so many celebrities with their Get Out the Vote campaign. Voting is important, don't you know? This is the most important election ever. What they really mean is vote for Hillary. If you need to be convinced, practically begged to go vote by celebrities, you're probably not the best voter in the world. And if people don't want to endorse anyone, let them. Taylor Swift gets so much crap because she won't talk about politics publicly.
Is she really pro-woman because she won't endorse Hillary Clinton?
She's smart not to endorse anybody and alienate some in her fan base, and she's done more by donating to charity than endorsing some politician. A popular YouTuber made this Hillary Clinton endorsement video.
Hillary Clinton. I will be voting for Hillary Clinton.
And at the end, he talked about how YouTubers shouldn't stay silent about our political views.
We have the power to ensure that this tax-avoiding, lying, racist, misogynist stays away from power and out of the White House. But it requires all of us coming together. So if your favorite YouTuber says things like, I don't like to talk politics on my channel, or I'm not going to reveal who I'm voting for, call them out. Sitting on the sidelines this time around is not okay.
Not everyone is comfortable discussing their political views on a public forum, especially when it has nothing to do with their channel. I'm actually a political YouTuber, and I think my subscribers can make up their own minds. I'm not saying don't vote, it's up to you to decide. Well, unless you're not informed about the candidates or the issues on election day, then do us a favor and stay home. But everyone has to have their voice heard. As if voting was the only way to make your voice heard. What are you saying if you vote for Hillary Clinton? Why, yes, I do want a no-fly zone over Syria, which could very well lead to war with Russia. NSA spying, drone strikes, Wall Street bailouts, all cool with me. What are you saying if you vote for Donald Trump? I'd like more frisking on the streets, higher tariffs, and fewer Mexicans, please. Jill Stein, in the wars, and vaccines are autism? Gary Johnson, legalize Aleppo? Just a joke. If none of those candidates represent your values, you're not making your voice heard by voting for them. There's also no obligation to vote for Hillary or Trump. Same people who say, you gotta vote, turn and say, oh no, you can't vote like that. Republicans say voting third party is a vote for Hillary. Democrats say voting third party is a vote for Trump. Make your voice heard.
But better choose red or blue.
I'm under no delusion about the chances of a third party candidate winning. Lots of people vote third party as a protest vote, and there's nothing wrong with that. Then there's the, well, if you don't vote, you can't complain. Psh, watch me. If you voted almost any of these people into office, I think you owe us an apology. Don't feel pressured to vote. Voting is optional. Thank goodness that we have that freedom. And it's a personal thing. Decide for yourself if you want to vote and who to vote for. Get informed. Don't vote like a dummy. And if anyone disagrees with your decision, let the haters hate.